Welcome to another episode in our Next.js Headless WordPress series. Currently, our site is using the default fonts. That means there is no consistency between the different operating systems like Windows, Linux, etc. So, in this video, I will show you how to change it and use a Google font instead. In order to set up fonts, there is a module, the font module, and it has several optimization features. For instance, it allows you to self-host the font files, which helps in avoiding external requests. It can work with Google Fonts as well. It can download the font files from Google servers and host it in your Next.js project directory and serve it from there. And when it comes to loading the font files, there are a couple of ways to do that. You can either add it to the app.js file to use it on all the pages, then export the component wrapped inside another element with that class name. Speaking of the fonts, there are two types of fonts available in Google Fonts: variable fonts and non-variable fonts. Here, Roboto is a non-variable font, and for non-variable fonts, you have to define the weight as well when loading it. Whereas for variable fonts, you don't need to specify the weights. It's all included in a single file. Also, if a font has a space in its name, you can replace that with an underscore when calling the function. An alternative to using the class name is to add a style attribute to the head section and then set the font family property. And finally, if you want to use the font in a single page only, then import the required font file in the route file itself. Then call it with the class name or by setting the font family property in a style tag. Okay, now let's go to the Google Fonts website to pick a font for our website. At the top itself, you can see a checkbox that allows toggling between variable and non-variable fonts. Currently, there are about 1490 font families in total. And out of these, around 298 are variable. The advantage of using a variable font is that you can use any variation with just a single font file. There is no need to download multiple font files for bold, italic, regular, thin, etc. Just a single file, which is better for performance. With variable weights, there is no need to limit yourself to fixed values like 300 for thin, 400 for regular, 700 for bold, like that. Okay, with that in mind, let's pick a font. I am going to use the Rubik font, which is a variable font. Let's take a look at the font page to see how the variable font mechanism is working. Go to the Type Tester tab, then slide the weight and you can see how the thickness is changing as I drag the slider. You can use any values between 300 and 900. You can also go with the predefined values like bold 700, regular 400, like that, if you want. And above that, there is also an option to enable or disable italics. Okay, back to the code editor. I plan to use the font within the single post page. That is the post slug.js route. So the first step is importing the font from Google Fonts. So import Rubik from next/font/google. But in order to use this, you need to ensure that the Next font module is installed for this project. I have it already installed. You can see it in the package.json file. It should be already available if you are using the latest version of Next.js. Otherwise, you can install it from npm. So if it's not already installed, just run the command npm install next/font. Also, in the latest version, there is no need to add the @ symbol in front of the module name. Once it's imported, you can call the font function and assign it to a constant. We want to get the Latin subset, so add Latin to the subsets property. You can also set the display property to swap. The default value will be optional. Change it to swap to make sure that the font is loaded correctly. Okay. Then output it to the console to see how it works. It should be an object. However, when I checked back on the page, there is a server error. So let me try refreshing the page. But still the error is there. So let me try restarting the development server by running npm run dev, then check the web page again, reloading the web page, and this time the error is gone. Now I want to open the Inspect Element tool, then go to the Console tab to see how the font object looks like. Here is the object. It has two properties, class name and style. And you can use this class name to assign the font to the elements you want. Within the style property, we have the font family and the font style. You can use this font family value inside custom CSS within a style tag if that's how you prefer to use it. Okay, I want to assign the font to our whole article, so let me set the class name attribute for the article tag. Article class name equals. Then inside a JSX block, let me call the class name using ruby.classname. Back to the web page, you can see that the font has already changed. Select the Inspect Element tool and hover over the element, and you can see that the font is now Rubik, so it's working. Checking the styles on the right side, you can see how the font family property for the class name is set to Rubik. And here you can see the class name assigned to the article tag. The class names are dynamically generated and the font module can automatically add the necessary CSS rules as well. Okay, next, suppose I want to use a different font for the heading. So how to import a second font? That's what we are going to discuss next. So once again, let's go to the Google Fonts website to pick a different font for the headings. And I think I can go with the Roboto slab font. It's a variable slab font. So in addition to Rubik, import Roboto slab as well. Rubik, Roboto slab. You can see how the space in the name changed to underscore. Now below that, we want to call the Roboto slab function and assign it to a constant called Roboto. By the way, make sure that the function name and the constant name are different. Here we are using lowercase letters for the constant name, while the function name has the first letter of the word in uppercase. Okay. Since Roboto slab is also a variable font, we need to set only the subset's value, that is Latin subset. And also the display value, set it to swap. Okay, now we are ready to use the Roboto slab font in our code, and I want to assign it to the h1 heading tag. So convert the class name value to JSX by putting it inside curly brackets and changing the double quotes to backticks. It allows you to use variable inside class name. Now we can call the class name variable robotoslab.classname. Okay, let's go back to the web page and check if it's working. However, the change isn't yet visible. I think there is some delay in downloading the font from Google servers. So let me try reloading the page. Okay, now it's working. You can see that the title is now using the Roboto slab font, while the rest of the page is still using the Rubik font. Now let's consider another case. Suppose I want to use Roboto slab for these list elements as well. There is no direct way to target the list elements because it's within the content area. And the content is fetched as a whole from the WordPress GraphQL API. So we need to target it using the postContent class assigned to the content area. In other words, there is no way for us to use the class name like we did just before. Instead, we have to set the font family property manually using some custom CSS code inside a style tag. And I want to add the style tag to the head section of the page. Within the style tag, open a JSX block. Wrap them inside backticks to preserve the line breaks. And within the backticks, we can target the list element using the class name of the parent element, that is .postContentUL. Then we can set the font family CSS property. Set its value to the variable robotoslab.style.fontfamily. Now going back to the web page, and you can already notice that the list items are using the Roboto slab font. So the inline styling is working. Checking on the right side under the styles section, you can see that the font family for post content UL is set to Roboto slab. whereas the remaining elements are still using Rubik, such as the paragraph elements, hyperlink, etc. Okay, I think that's all for this video, but there is one thing I must mention here. Initially, I had a hard time getting the font module to work. I got some weird alerts like this and the fonts were not loading properly, especially in the development mode. So I had to actually build the site and then start the production server, and then the fonts started working. Still, I'm not sure why the error occurred, but in case you are also facing the same issue, you might want to try building the site. I think there may be some issue when the module is trying to download the font files from the remote server. Even when trying to run the build command, I got some build errors. The error message says fetch failed, so it must be a network issue. Without making any further changes, I just tried to build the site again using npm run build, and this time it worked. Most probably it must be an error from my side, and there may not be anything wrong with the module itself. Okay, in the second attempt, the build completed successfully. So let me start the production server using npm run start. Then checking the web page, reload the page, and now everything is working as expected. Both the fonts are loading correctly, RobotoSlab and Rubik. And during the build process, I have already said that Next will download all the required font files, as well as generate the necessary CSS and store it inside the static folder. What you are looking at now is the CSS file generated by the font module. You can see the names RobotoSlab and Rubik being used inside the style sheet. You may also check the Chrome network tab to see where the font files are actually downloaded from. And it's downloaded from the localhost server itself. That is the same server, not from the remote server. And speaking of the font files, it's stored inside the media directory. I hope it's clear. One last thing I want to mention is that if you are using the latest version of Next.js, then there is no need to use the @ symbol in front of the module name. And as I am recording this video, Next.js is at version 13.2.4. Here is the default webpage that comes along when you install Next.js the first time. And in that, it's using the inter font, which is another variable font. And this is how the font class name is set for the various elements, in this case a paragraph element. Okay, I hope now you understand how to change fonts in a Next.js site using the font module. I hope the video was useful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.